I'm the commander of the guard here in Whiterun.
Good to know. Let's go tell Yara what we did.
Good. You're finally here. The Jarl's been waiting for you.
He has.
You heard the summons. What else could it mean?
The Greybeards.
We were just talking about you. My brother needs a word with you.
Where are you now?
So what happened at the watchtower? Was the dragon there?
Turns out I may be something called Dragonborn.
Dragonborn? What do you know about the Dragonborn?
When the dragon died, I absorbed some kind of power from it.
So it's true. The Greybeards really were summoning you.
The Greybeards?
Masters of the Way of the Voice. They live in seclusion, high on the slopes of the throat of the world.
What do these Greybeards want with me?
The Dragonborn is said to be uniquely gifted in the voice. The ability to focus your vital essence into a thume or shout. If you really are Dragonborn, they can teach you how to use your gift.
Ain't nobody higher.
Did you hear the thundering sound as you returned to Whiterun? That was the voice of the Greybeards summoning you to High Hrothgar. This hasn't happened in centuries, at least. Not since Tiber Septim himself was summoned when he was still Talos of Atmora.
Rungar, calm yourself. What does any of this Nord nonsense have to do with our friend here? Capable as he may be, I don't see any signs of him being this, what, Dragonborn.
Nord nonsense? Why, you puffed up ignorant. These are our sacred traditions that go back to the founding of the First Empire.
Rungar, don't be so hard on Avinich.
I meant no disrespect, of course. It's just that, what do these Greybeards want with him?
That's the Greybeards' business, not ours. Whatever happened when you killed that dragon, it revealed something in you, and the Greybeards heard it. If they think you're Dragonborn, who are we to argue? You'd better get up to High Hrothgar immediately. There is no refusing the summons of the Greybeards. It's a tremendous honor. I envy you, you know?
Hmm?
To climb the 7,000 steps again. I made the pilgrimage once. Did you know that? High Hrothgar is a very peaceful place. Very disconnected from the troubles of this world. I wonder that the Greybeards even notice what's going on down here. They haven't seemed to care before. No matter. Go to High Hrothgar. Learn what the Greybeards can teach you. You've done a great service for me and my city, Dragonborn. By my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Whiterun. It's the greatest honor that's within my power to grant. I assign you Lydia as a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble, now would we? We are honored to have you as Thane of our city, Dragonborn. Back to business, Proventus. We still have a city to defend.
Yes, my lord.
I'm the Dragonborn? What a lord of horker crap. Hey, Lucien.
I've been trying to train our mud crab to fetch things. So far, he... well, he totally ignores me, really.
What do you know about the Dragonborn?
Ah. You're convinced that that's what you are, then?
Kind of. It certainly looks like that way.
It's true, the evidence does seem to suggest that. But I think a certain degree of skepticism is in order. Tests, not superstition. That's how we'll find out exactly what you are. Anyway, you asked me what I know. I'm more familiar with the Cyrodiilic legends than the Nordic ones, but I'll tell you what I've read. Though some scholars on Solstheim dispute it, the first definite use of the term Dragonborn is attributed to Saint Alessia, back in the First Era. The story goes that on her deathbed, Alessia made a pact with Akatosh, who infused her with his divine blood and granted her the Amulet of Kings. Akatosh then sealed off the Plains of Oblivion, banishing the Aedra and Daedra from the surface of Nirn forevermore. Or at least, for as long as one of Alessia's descendants sat on the throne of Cyrodiil and wore the amulet. From then on, Alessia's descendants were known as Dragonborn. Of course, that line ended with the death of Martin Septim during the Oblivion Crisis.
Mm-hmm.
But he turned into a giant dragon and kicked Maerun's Dagon back into the Deadlands, which seems to have confused things. Anyway, skip ahead a couple of hundred years, and here you are, supposedly with that same dragon blood in your veins. The somewhat primitive Nordic myths claim that lets you absorb the soul of a dragon, which we've both seen you do, and channel it into a shout. But as far as I'm aware, no one ever saw any of the Dragonborn Emperors do that. Maybe you're related to them. Maybe the gods just like you. In any case, as I said, I have a feeling we'll find out more soon enough.
Okay,
let's get moving.
Sure.
Another wanderer here to lick my father's boots. Good job.
What is it?
Bye then.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your house, Carl. It's an honor to serve you.
Okay. You stay here. I'll come back for you later.
Until next time.
You've been a good friend to me. That means something.
Let's go to High Hrothgar then.
Well, I don't like the rift is truly something. Just look at these leaves. You don't typically see anything like them anywhere else in Skye.
You ever settle down to have children? Twice.
Why not? We'd be going up the steps anyway.
Ah, you must be referring to me talking to Klimek.
The Greybeards, then? Sounds intriguing. If they can tell us anything more about that shouting business, I'd say it's worth the trip.
Yep. Very hard to see. Maybe we should have stopped in the inn.
Sure looks like a big old mountain up close like this. Can't wait to start climbing.
That'll be fine, Lucien. I mean, after all, we've done it before. Hello there.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar. Aye.
Did you hear the Greybeards call Dovahkiin?
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
What are you doing?
I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
Do you visit the Greybeards?
They're not the sort to take visitors. But I never go that high up the path anyway. Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials. But not to make conversation.
Ah, looks like the sky's clearing a little bit. Hey, Remy, Lucien, are you guys cold? Apparently so. Wait, where's Remy? Ah. Oh, she's cold. She's only wearing a friggin' shirt.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
Did you hear the Greybeards call Dovahkiin?
I was just outside Iverstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Nothing like this has happened in centuries.
Who are you?
Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
Sure. What are you doing?
Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Until next time.
Can I ask you a question now? Just one?
As long as it's just one.
How exactly does drinking blood work? Do you need it to survive?
I technically don't really need it to survive, but I do.
Another one of those emblems. I really hope I don't have to keep doing this.
You'd never catch me up this early when I was a student.
Is that so, Lucien? Mix supplies in here.
Wow, this temple truly looks like something else.
Remy, you don't look so good. Okay.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
I'm answering your summons.
We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
Fine.
Strike us with the power of your voice. Boosh! Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn. Why have you come here?
Who are you? What is this place? You've told me your name, but you haven't exactly told me much.
We are the Greybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice. You stand in High Hrothgar, on the slopes of Kinnarith's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice of the sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves.
I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
You mean I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
I'm answering your summons, Master.
We are honored to welcome a dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny.
What is my destiny?
That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination.
I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path? Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will
nice
now
job.
Teach you
Roll, you passed the first
the second
test.
Word in
and
unrelenting
well,
force.
You are learning quickly.
Roll means
anyway,
balance.
Let's move.
The dragon tongue.
I think you have one more.
Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Roll.
More of those strange symbols. Really?
As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of rope. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the target. Well done. Again.
Incredible. The architect is truly something.
You learn quickly. Once more. Thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragon. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Boy.
Okay.
Master Bori will teach you wood, which means well. You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thing.
I'm no fan of the sun. It would be better than this.
Okay, let's give this a try.
Quick mastery of a new thumb is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself.
I thought it was this easy for everyone.
No, indeed not. But beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengraf. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return.
Why are the dragons returning? Does it have something to do with me?
No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear.
Surely there's more you can tell me. That's nowhere near enough.
There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it. Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many Dragonborn before you.
What does it mean to be Dragonborn?
Dragons have the inborn ability to learn and project their voice. Dragons also are able to absorb the power of their slain brethren. A few mortals are born with similar abilities, whether a gift or a curse has been a matter of debate down through the centuries. What you have already learned in a few days took even the most gifted of us years to achieve. Some believe that Dragonborn are sent into the world by the gods at times of great need. We will speak more of that later, when you are ready.
Why are shouts in the dragon language?
Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating
Look,
and fighting.
A snowflake.
Shouting
Look,
comes as naturally
snowflake.
To a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, dragon speech is in your blood, and you learn it almost without effort.
There are only four of you?
Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him.
When can I meet your leader, Partanax?
As I said, you will know you are ready when your voice can open the path to him.
Tell me about the Greybeards.
We study the way of the voice according to the teachings of our founder, Jürgen Windcaller. Very few are permitted to study with us here at High Hrothgar. But in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery of your voice.
Why don't the others talk?
Their voices are too powerful for anyone not trained in the way to withstand. Even a whisper could kill you.
Oh? Who was Jürgen Windcaller?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, the master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
What is the way of the voice?
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
But I don't follow your philosophy. Why help me learn the voice?
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals. Breath and focus.
So, we need the horn of Jürgen Windcaller. And where is it? In a dungeon full of Draugr, of course. Where else would you keep a musical instrument?
Okay, Lucien. Let's go find ourselves a horn.
Dragonborn.
The Greybeards seem to think so.
Then it is too late. The lie has already taken root in the hearts of men. So we shall expose to them the falseness in their hearts by tearing out yours, deceiver. When Lord Mirak appears, all shall bear witness. None shall stand to oppose him.
Nice try.
Whoa. You know what you're doing with those flames there.
Summon the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened. Hundreds.
Sorry, after you.
I hope you like it. It's a special thing for you.
Please. Not now.
He's not bad.
Not now.
He's not.
Someone just tried to kill me.
But then I took an arrow to my heart. You're a great shot, love.
Serana, what did I just say? Huh? Oh, I'm giving that a read later. Oh dear. Who are these people, and why did they try to hurt me? Okay. Board the vessel Northern Maiden, docked at Ravenrock. Take it to Windhelm, then begin your search. Kill the false dragonborn known as Ren before he reaches Solstheim. Return with word of your success, and Mirak shall be most pleased. Huh.
Are you alright?
Yeah, it looks like I'm fine.
That was a close one. I didn't expect to be jumped on like that.
And neither did I.
Ridiculous mask they wore. Very tacky. Good to know that cultists will always be the same, no matter what era. Could I read that note you've been reading? Thanks. I recall an old book about this cult in the castle's library. This Mirak, though,
I've read some stories about him. He was supposed to be the first dragonborn who ever lived.
Huh?
He was around long before even I was. This might be worth looking into.
You ready for Ustengrav?
I am, actually. Now, I might have felt a bit nervous, just a bit, but I've seen you in action, so I'm pretty confident we'll do great. Between your thume and my magic, we could tackle just about any foe.
Don't interrupt me while I'm thinking.
That's great. I'm glad you're here with me too.
Likewise. Let's get moving, mighty hero.
You got anything to say about that, Lucien?
Well, well, well. Dragonborn. Now with the Greybeard's seal of approval and a bunch of shiny mystical powers to boot. Do you have any idea how exciting this is for me? To be able to study the Thume up close and with such regularity. I must write this all up. No other scientist in Tamriel has this kind of opportunity.
What a waste.
Onlyo.
Hey, Ren.
So. Tiny horse. All right, let's head to Ustengrav. Really like that shot. I get to fly, at least for a few seconds. I wonder what Ustengrav is, though. Ongir said it was a tomb for Jürgen Windcaller. But it can't be just for him. After all the other ancient Nordic tombs we've been in, house hundreds of Draugr and corpses. About to die now that I've got a purpose. Why were you doing Skooma? All right, Ustengrav. Whoa. Can't see anything.
Looks like we're here. Let's get to it, shall we?
What do you think I'm about to do, Serana? You don't like, I don't know, cast a light? Something I can't see. That's done.
Yeah, this place seems great. Ustengrav, party capital of Skyrim. Oh wait, my mistake. It's horrendous.
I have to agree with you there. After all, there's necromancers in here. Wonder what they're doing in here, though.
Like.
I agree with you there. I mean, maybe solitude might outdo it there, but that's a little bit biased. After all, I own a mansion there. Alright, let's continue my adventuring party. Alright, we need to go through here. Maybe?
Surely, all these years, these ruins can't still be structurally stable. Sorry, just thinking out loud.
Way to make me feel a little uneasy, Lucien. You need to work out more. Because every time we go adventuring, that's all I hear, Remyal. See, I'm not like that. I like all the people. Meh, beast folk, men. I just particularly hate the Thalmor. And that's kind of why they sent Justicias to kill me. Because I kind of, sort of, broke someone out of their prison. Well, not prison, Northwatch Keep. But, need I say more?
Looks like we're making some progress here. I certainly do hope this is all worth it. This ruin is rather sprawling, a bit confusing at times. Let's continue. Who's there?
That one, that's not nice.
Who's there?
My attempted sneak did not work. Making some progress here, though, I will admit. Oh. Let's see if we can find a way to open that, but first... Oh. Let's have a little dig at this. The pull lever there. And there's gotta be a second one somewhere. Ah, I guess I didn't see it. What is in here? Potion, soul gem, a dagger, healing, and a chest. Let's see if we've got anything we can disenchant.
Set the metal rods at 45 degree angles for optimal support. It's the steam pressure. But would that leave enough space for the gears?
Not that I can see. Onwards, my friends. We have the Greybeard's trial to finish. Ouch, my head is severely in pain, and I don't have any spell that I can do at range. What scrolls? Do I have a scroll? We'll use this one. Come on, guys, I'm exploring. Kill them! I was about to say, Sorana, behind you. Good job, team. I totally helped in that case. I want to take a look around, though. Especially down there. Question is, how do we get down? That's another one of those walls. No, I really want to get down there. Maybe I can... Well, That's one way to get down. What do you have?
Oh, great job, Remy. Now you're bleeding all over the place.
Ah, you'll be fine. Drink a potion. Thank you for the light, Serana. Totally, totally what I need. Okay. Okay. That's totally helpful. I was about to say I could not find the lever anywhere though. And we're totally fine. We're not fine. We are not fine. Team. Thank you. Where's the horn? Where's the horn?
Well, that was an anticlimax. What does the note say?
Someone wants to meet me at the Sleeping Giant Inn in Riverwood.
And presumably that someone has this horn the Greybeards are so desperate for you to fetch them.
Yep.
How very mysterious. Shall we go and see?
Yes, let's go see.
Bye for now.
Because now I'm actually a little bit angry.
Do you need something?
Damn it! Well, isn't it wonderful? We trudge through this sprawling borough, face mortal peril every turn, solve deadly puzzles, and what reward awaits us? A scrap of paper with someone's scrawls? What a fascinating learning experience. And the worst part is, why not just send a note like any sane person would? Why make us plod through the whole damn tomb? Did they think it'd be funny? Or was it some kind of test?
A test? More like a cruel jest. I intend to repay it in kind when we meet.
To express your immense disappointment, that is. I hope we can make sense of this nonsense when we find the author of this note. Let's get moving.
I'm just gonna get the note, and then we're gonna let go. They can buzz off. Oh, a lot of money. I'll, gladly take... And what's in here? I know where we are. Wait a second. Yeah, I know where we are. We're right back where I thought we'd be. And I still can't see anything.